welcome to Tech TV. I'm your host, Haleema Sadia. Joining us today is Ward 2 resident and candidate for City Council, Ayushe Sharman. As a former journalist, Ayushe has worked with Mayor Boni Crombie and several Mississauga councillors. Later entering politics to work for Premier of Ontario, the Honourable Doug Ford, and former Lieutenant Governor of Ontario, the Honourable Hilary Weston. Recently opening up her own production house to cater advertising to small businesses and political campaigns. Thank you for joining us today, Ayushe. So let's start with, as you know, Mississauga 2022 municipal elections are coming up quickly on October 24. How has campaign been like for you?
So it's been an incredibly valuable experience. Ever since the beginning of the campaign, we've knocked on thousands of doors, listening to the concerns and ideas of Ward 2 Mississauga residents, as well as local organizations who are doing great, and hearing about their initiatives of bringing in more resources to their respective neighborhoods. So I think when you meet one-on-one with all the residents living in the community that you are contesting to be a strong voice for, and listen to their hopes and their ideas, and they're also their struggles, it kind of gives you a very good understanding of the direction that you should be going in.
So what motivated you towards the politics?
So politics has been ingrained in me ever since I was really young. My parents have always kept up with news, and they always taught my brother and I to have the courage to go out and change anything we wish to in the community that we see lacking. Canada and Ontario in general, and Ward 2 in Mississauga specifically, has a lot of potential to be a forever home for our upcoming generations, where they can work with great companies or start their own, or raise their families and have a good quality of life. But what we're seeing is, because we're lagging and we have these housing crisis and we don't have enough support for our small businesses, a lot of our young adults are now looking south of the border for a good life. So this is a big no-no, and we need to fix problems locally, which I started doing as soon as I decided to run for this position. And somehow fix this migration that is now starting to take place by looking at the issues on the ground.
As you're running for the first time for city politics, so which kind of experiences you think are making you a qualified candidate?
So this is my first time running. However, I've been in politics for a very long time, and I'm well aware of what residents expect from their elected officials, as well as their governing bodies. I started in politics as a journalist, so I was trained to assess public policy as being critical of it, as well as its impact on residents of varying demographics. Then I also worked with Premier Doug Ford and the PC caucus, the former Lieutenant Governor of Ontario, as well as on various provincial and federal campaigns. So I have seen firsthand how policies and political decisions are made, and which ones have worked the best thus far.
So what kind of unique skills or perspective do you think you can bring to Ward 2 if you're elected?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So ever since the beginning of the campaign, as I mentioned, that we've rigorously door knocked and talked to thousands of residents, I think one issue that we see as an underlying sentiment in every issue of theirs is that they want to have a say. I feel people don't know who to reach out to if they have service or safety related issues, as well as they feel that they're not consulted enough about changes that are coming into their own neighborhoods. So I think this is what I'm looking to eradicate in Ward 2, at least, where I want to have regular town hall meetings and consultations with residents that are separated by neighborhoods and are situated locally in those neighborhoods, so they're not going too far to join these meetings, as well as working with local organizations to get those residents involved who haven't been involved, and informing them about what the city is working on and how they can have a say.
What kind of challenges Ward 2 is facing, and how do you think you can tackle them?
So I think major issues that are being faced by the community at this time in Ward 2 Mississauga is lack of housing for young adults and seniors looking to downsize. Second is high property taxes, and third is lack of police presence. So when it comes to housing, I have proposed in my platform as well that we give a green light to low to mid-rise buildings in our around our MTSA, which is major transit station area, which is our Clarkson GO station area. There is some space there where we can put these buildings, which will be mixed use in nature. So we reserve the first floor for medical amenities, as well as mini marts, restaurants, recreational activities. And it can be home to seniors who are looking to downsize and young adults who are starting out their families who commute frequently to downtown. So the Clarkson GO station being right there and the bus station being right there, we are also taking cars off the roads. So that's there, and bringing in small businesses by making them mixed use and giving people a lot of amenities living there as well as in neighborhoods near them. Then second thing was property taxes. This issue we're gonna see getting worse because Mississauga 2023 budget is indicating that our property taxes will go up by 5.7%. So I will urge, and if elected, I will strongly urge the new council to work together and assess the budget and find any efficiencies we can to lower those property taxes, because anyway, even right now, residents are finding them unreasonably high and difficult to pay for, especially seniors on fixed incomes. That being said, lastly, the lack of presence, lack of police presence. I think it's time we talk to the police. We have consultation with the police and bring in more services into the neighborhood, because fortunately, crime rates have been low in Ward 2. However, we're seeing issues with speeding as well as car thefts on the rise. And before things get too worse, we need the residents to feel that they're not on their own.
Why do you think that the people of Mississauga should vote for you in upcoming elections?
So 21% of Mississauga's population is between the ages of 20 and 34. Don't you think it's time that the council reflect the demographics of the city? We as a younger generation know what it's like to be a recent graduate with debt who is now looking to buy a new home, their first home, looking to raise a family, efficiently commute to our jobs, as well as take care of our elders. So we're going through those experiences, and we can advocate better for our generation as well as our next generation and our previous generations. And that being said, I value the expertise on our council at this time. However, we need younger people to do those rigorous consultation with residents, do the groundwork, digitally connect residents to rest of the council, as well as bring in technological advancements to put forth modern solutions to time-old problems. For example, eco-friendly transit options that can help us get across the city faster, also while reducing our carbon emissions, or newer technologies that can help us reduce speeding and noise levels on the roads.
So it's a very good said, very well said, that we need new generation to give new energy, new level of understanding and new blood into the politics, so that we can look forward for a couple of years for a drastic change as it is happening. I thank you very much, Ayushe, for joining us today in the studio.
Thank you for having me.
And thank you to our viewers for tuning in. This is Haleema Sadia, and you're watching Tech TV. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to keep up to date on all of our latest content.